February's record snowfall has forced the snow clearing team to work around the clock to keep the airport open. But there have been casualties.
These are the damages that they've done just since last night.
The airfield's 6,000 lights are one of the biggest reasons Ted Stevens can stay open, even in the most savage snowstorms. But as snow is cleared from the runways, the lights become collateral damage.
Without these taxiway lights, it's very difficult for the planes to navigate on their own. And it could lead them to getting too close to another aircraft. Wingtips could touch.
Over 60 lights are out of action. Electrician Dennis Deering, known as Beeve, needs to repair them before nightfall.
We kind of clear up the mess the snowplows make.
To get to the first taxiway, Beeve crosses 2 miles of busy airfield, where a plane takes off or lands every 4 minutes.
You can see how deep these lights get buried. They haven't cleared these yet. When they do, we're going to have a lot of damage. As an airfield electrician, it's just a constant battle here. It seems like you just get through on one end of the field and you start over again on the other end. These are in really good shape. They did a great job on these. We're hardly finding any that are knocked down.
But 200 feet further down the taxiway, Beeve finds 2 casualties.
So this ought to be something we should fix. This is called the coupling, and there's a weak point right on that coupling right there where it's designed to break away. It's called a frangible.
The lights are designed to collapse if they're hit by a plane or snowplow. The frangible breaks easily, leaving the rest of the light intact.
Everything looks good on this fixture, so all we need to do is get through the ice, replace the frangible, and throw the fixture back in. This time of year, I mean, there's a lot of ice over this. This frangible is recessed a little bit. It fills up with ice. We got to chisel that away. We get a lot of corrosion. We're right near the ocean, so this is a pretty corrosive environment. We got to make sure we anti-seize everything up. If these connections are damaged, we'll bring it back and rebuild it, or if the light bulb is out or lens is broken, we'll bring it back in and rebuild it. But it's a lot of work rebuilding all these things, so if we don't have to, we usually just put them right back.
The second broken light needs a little more work.
So those connections are bent. We're not going to reuse this one. So 2 lights out in a row is really the biggest problem, because 3 lights out shuts down the taxiway. And so whenever we see 2 in a row, that means it's time for some action. We really need to take care of the problem.
Removing the fixing in an inch of ice is no easy task.
Here's a new frangible. A little bit of anti-seize on it. This nasty stuff gets all over your fingers and it goes everywhere.
The lights are powered by a 2-mile circuit built under the asphalt.
This is just a 30-watt lamp, but under the ground, this is a 5,000-volt system. So it's actually a very dangerous system to work on. If anything goes wrong underground, 5,000 volts with the amperage we're running, it would be enough to burn limbs off. It would definitely kill you. There's no way you would survive it if you took a good hit across your body with this. There we go. Looks like we found everything on this taxiway. After you've been doing this for about 6 months, you about can't stand the thought of putting up another blue light. Come April, you're glad to see that sun come back.